Hey again, everybody. This is the final part of my process video. As you can see, this is the finished piece, and this is what I uploaded to my Tumblr. So, as you can see, I decided that I really liked the halftone look, and I liked that printed kind of manga-esque pattern. So I decided to keep that, and I also overlaid some pink on it, and I decided in the end that I didn't want all those colors competing with each other, and maybe I'll go back and make a colored version later, but as of now I really like this pink look, because I don't know, I like the juxtaposition of even though it's kind of, I wouldn't say trite or cliche, but I've definitely seen it done of, these kind of gnarly visual elements with the soft, kind of feminine associated pink. So that's what I did with that. And the way I did that, man, I'm surprised at how much I didn't organize the titles of these layers, but that's neither here nor there. So I've got this layer set to overlay at 91% opacity, and that's because I gray toned everything by just sliding the saturation down, and then I half toned it, and then I didn't like how light it was originally, so I just made a multiply layer of so right here, here are the original colors that were gray, and I thought that it was still a little light, so I made a second layer and set it to multiply and put it at about 54%. Because when it's full, it's good, but I didn't like it quite that dark. I still wanted to have some lightness to it, so I set that to 54%. Let's see. Here is the actual line work that is above it. Let's see, is there anything else I did that was interesting? I don't really think so. Let me delete that layer. Yeah, it's it was pretty simple. Getting it to this stage, this was all I really wanted to do with it, and it's kind of like how I was saying in my last video that I start out with a plan and then I kind of go for it. But if I want to play around, I leave room to really mess with things. And let's see, real quick. I can pull up my other one. Oh, that's another comic project I'm working on for someone. I'm pretty sure I called it Self-Stab Dude. I think's what I named this. Let's see. Here we go. Let's see if my original has the colors in it. I think it does. And we can compare for the sake of this video, because I don't really have a whole lot more to say about it. But once it opens, yeah, with this, let's see, there I made an overlay layer. This is kind of originally what I was working with, and as you can see, I wasn't liking it where it was going. I felt like everything was kind of competing with each other, and I thought that comparatively speaking, here, let me separate these. I thought that comparatively speaking, let me fit that to the screen too. I don't know. I just liked the look of it more when it had this uniform monochromatic color scheme. And another tip for y'all who are or who haven't played around much with your layers and stuff. It's easy with this doing an overlay layer too, because then you can just go into your hue saturation window and just start playing around with another hue. If you wanted to, let's say, do a more gray, version of that stuff that kind of looks cool. Maybe you could even darken it to bring out those shadows, or whatever, really. And this is normally what I do too. I'll stick with my idea, but I'll definitely play around to see, oh, should there be more red in that pink or whatever. And then it's always good to kind of preview and contrast and stuff. So this is what I ended up going with, because I just like the way this print look gave me, and I like the way that the uniformity of giving it a monochromatic color scheme was. So Yeah, that's pretty much it, and this is what I go through when I make a piece. So, I think that's really about all. And if you guys have any questions or comments or what have you, feel free to leave them, and I will try to get back to everybody who's interested. So, thanks a lot for sticking with it if you've stuck with it to the end, and maybe I'll make another one of these in the future, getting even more detailed or doing something that is fully colored, who knows. So I will see you guys again later, or on my art blog. Follow me at zacharyxbinks.tumblr.com, and in the very near future I'm gonna have a website, so I'll let you guys know about that. Okay, bye.